Silver Mind. Today I'm going to tell you everything about the non-alignment movement. After the Second World War, 1939 to 1945, the Cold War divided the world into two rival alliances, USA and USSR. This map shows the division in Europe. Newly decolonized countries of Asia, Africa, and Latin America did not join either alliance. This was called the non-alignment movement. Countries in yellow depict the countries which were led by USA. Countries in red depict the countries which were led by USSR. Countries in green were called the third world countries. The roots of NAM went back to the friendship between three leaders, Yugoslavia's Josip Broz Tito, India's Jawaharlal Nehru, and Egypt's leader Gamal Abdel Nasser, who held a meeting in 1956. Indonesia's Sukarno and Ghana's Kwame Nkrumah strongly supported them. These five leaders came to be known as the five founders of NAM. The first non-aligned summit was held in Belgrade in 1961. Factors that led to the NAM were cooperation among these five countries, growing Cold War tensions and its widening arenas, and the dramatic entry of many newly decolonized African countries into the international arena. By 1960, there were 16 new African members in the UN. The first summit was attended by 25 member states. Over the years, the membership of NAM has expanded. The latest meeting, the 18th summit of the non-alignment movement, was held in October 25-26, 2019, in Baku, Azerbaijan. The summit was attended by a delegation from more than 120 countries. As non-alignment grew into a popular international movement, countries of various different political systems and interests joined it. This made the movement less homogeneous and also made it more difficult to define in very neat and precise terms. NAM was easier to define in terms of what it was not. It was not about being a member of an alliance. Was non-alignment isolationism? Non-alignment is also not isolationism, since isolationism remains aloof from world affairs. In comparison, the non-aligned countries, including India, played an active role in mediating between the two rival alliances in the cause of peace and stability. Their strength was based on their unity and their resolve to remain non-aligned despite the attempt by the two superpowers to bring them into their alliances. Was non-alignment neutrality? Non-alignment is also not neutrality. Neutrality refers principally to a policy of staying out of war. States practicing neutrality are not required to help end a war. They do not get involved in wars and do not take any position on the appropriateness or morality of a war. Non-aligned states, including India, were actually involved in wars for various reasons. They also worked to prevent war between others and tried to end wars that had broken out. Although a virtual summit was held in 2020, it is not recognized as the 19th summit. I hope you found the video interesting. Like, comment, and share. Subscribe to the channel for more videos. Thank you.